Okay, so in this video, we are going to see how to set up Flutter with Windows system. So first of all, you have to go to this link, docs.flutter.dev. And in this link, I will be sharing this link in the description so you can see this link. So go to this link and you will see all these options. So you can set up Flutter for Windows, macOS, Linux, and Chrome OS. So for this video, we'll be going for Windows. So let's click on Windows. And you can see your system requirements, which is needed to set up Flutter in your system. And then this is the Flutter which you need. So what you have to do, click on it and download the zip folder. So I've already downloaded it, so I won't do it. So the first thing is go to this link and download this zip folder. And then if you see, I have already downloaded it. And I have also created a folder in my C. So in my C directory, I've created this Flutter folder. So what I'll do is I will extract the content of this downloaded folder into the C folder. So right click and then extract all. And I will extract it to my C folder. Folder Flutter. So I'll extract everything over here and then select folder. And this should extract everything. Okay, so this will take some time. So let's wait for it. Okay, so now the extract has completed successfully and we have a new Flutter folder and you can see all these files and folders are already there. So what you need to do is go to this bin folder and copy this part. Copy this part because we will be setting it in the environment variable. So after copying it, you have to search for environment in environment. So edit the system environment variable. That is what you need to go for. So open that and you will see something like this. So what you need to set is environment variable. So go for it. And there are two options. One is user variable and one is system variable. So in the user variables, what you need to do is select this part and double click on it. And what you need to do is create new entry and paste your part, which we just copied. So our Flutter part we just copied and then click on OK and then click on OK again. And this should set the Flutter to your Windows system. So after setting this up, Flutter is all set up to use in your Windows system. So to test whether Flutter is properly set up or not, what you need to do is open command prompt and just say Flutter dash dash version. Now, so as you can see, it says Flutter 3.0.0 channel stable has been set up properly in your system. So this is fine. This is good. Now, what we need to do, we need to set up another things like Android Studio and VS Code. Before that, let's run one command saying Flutter Doctor, and it will tell you what and all is pending in your system to start writing your code in Flutter. So as you can see, it says Flutter channel stable is installed properly. So there is a check mark, but it says Android toolchain is not installed. So there is a cross. There is a red cross. So it says that you need to install it if you want to use Flutter for creating Android application. And then for Chrome, it is installed properly because Chrome is already there in your system. If Chrome is not there, then it will be cross as well. So you can create web application using Flutter as well. And then VS Code is also not installed if you want it. So this is in yellow because VS Code is not mandatory. You can write your code on Android Studio as well. And Android Studio is also not mandatory. So these two are not mandatory, but Android Studio you will require if you want to create a mobile application. Let's install Android Studio first. So if you go at the bottom, it will tell you how to set up Android as well. So you have to download and install Android Studio. So let's go to this link. And then we have this download Android Studio option. So let's just click on it. Agree on all the agreements and let it download. So let's wait for it to download and then we will install it in our Windows system. Now the Android Studio exe file has been downloaded successfully. So let's just double click on it and then you should get something like this. Welcome to Android Studio. Just click on next. Whenever you want to install it, I will leave it over here, so click on Next. And install, so this will take some time to install Android Studio in your Windows. So let's wait for it. Once this has completed, click on Next again. And it will say start in our studios. And so we do want to do that. So let's click on Finish and let it start Android Studio. So we do not have any prior installation config. So do not import settings and click on OK. And it will start Android Studio. Click on Next and then Next. And I want this one. So let's click on Next. And click on Next. Accept it. And Android SDK license as well. Accept this. And Android SDK preview license. Accept this. And then click on Finish. So this has finished, but you can see some errors. So we can ignore this error for now. Do not worry about this. If you're not getting any error, then that's good. But I'm getting this error, but I'll ignore it for now and click on Finish. So once you're finished, it will show you the screen. And what you can do is go to SDK Manager. So let's go to SDK Manager and then go to SDK Tools and just select this Android SDK command line tools. So once you have selected this, click on Apply and confirm changes. That is fine. Click on OK and then let it install it. Once this is installed, click on Finish. Click on OK and then go to your command prompt. And run your Flutter doctor command again. And this will show you your current status. So as you can see, it says that Android Studio is installed. And the only problem with Android is Android toolchained. So to resolve this, run Flutter doctor Android license. So we have to copy this command, Control C, then Control V, and then it will ask you to accept some license. So let's do that. So click on Y and enter. Y and enter. Y and enter. Y and enter. And it's all accepted. So now if we run Flutter Doctor, all issues related to Android Studio should disappear. So let's run it. Okay, so as you can see, Android toolchain, it's green and Android Studio is also green. So all we need is Visual Studio now. So let's go to our Google, say Visual Studio code. So this is what we need. And then go to downloads and then download for Windows. So once it is downloaded, just double click on it. Accept the increment. Click on next. Click on next and install. So once this is installed, you will see this screen. Just click on finish and it will launch VS Code. Now from here, you can create new applications. So let's open a new folder. So I'll create a new application in my C Flutter directory itself. So I had created in C Flutter and I'll just create new folder over here and I'll say projects. So I will save all my projects in this folder and select this folder. And since there's nothing, it won't show nothing. So just trust it first. And then in the terminal, you will open new terminal. So you can create new project using Flutter command. That is Flutter create. And then your project name. So I'll say my project. Just first project. And then click on it. And it should start creating your project in this directory. And there you go. So this is our project you can see in this folder. So we have to open this folder now. So if we go and say open folder and we go in project, this is my project and you can say select folder. So we are in our application now. So now to run this application, what you need to do is go to extensions and download Flutter from this extension. So type Flutter and then install. And there is some awesome Flutter snippets. So you can install these as well. It will really help you. Okay, so Flutter package has been installed now. So now I can go ahead and run my application. So let's close this. And to run your application, if you see over here, run And in this, you have this option, start debugging. So if you click on it, so it will give you options. So select Dart and Flutter from these options. Okay, so your VSCODE is ready and your extension is also ready. You can run your application, but you do not have Android Emulator. So to do so, let's install one Android Emulator. So let's open our Android Studio first, and then we will install one Android Emulator so that we can run our application. So let's wait for Android Studio. And now in the More Actions, as you can see, it says Virtual Device Manager. So click on Virtual Device Manager, and as you see, we do not have any emulator. So click on Create Virtual Device Manager, and you can create TV, phone, tablet, Wear OS, all these things. So what we need is we just need a simple phone emulator, Android phone emulator. So I'll just select Pixel and then click on Next. You will have to download one of the OS so I can download this R itself. So let's wait for it to install. Okay, now the install has been done. So we can click on this Finish, and then I can select it and click on Next. And this is the specification for your Android emulator. So everything is fine. So click on Finish. And now you can see your Pixel XL API Kodi emulator ready. So I can run it from here. So let's wait for it. Okay, so now our Android emulator is ready. It is giving some pop-up, so we can ignore it. Click on OK. So as you can see, since this Android emulator is ready, in my VS Code, in the selected device, it has automatically selected Android SDK, this Android emulator, which we have just created, PixelXL. So this is selected now. You have to make sure that this is selected, and then click on Run and start debugging. And now, as you can see, the application is running successfully in our Android emulator. So this is the sample project which Flutter gives, and it is running successfully in our emulator. So this is it with this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you like, then please do subscribe and like and comment.